warm welcome to all of you who are watching this interview today. Today we have with us a very special guest. We have Mr. Satyarup Siddhanta, who is a mountaineer. He was born and brought up in West Bengal, and he pursued his engineering in Sikkim, and he's been in Bangalore for the past 9 years. Every mountaineer has a dream to conquer the 7 summits in the world, which means climbing the highest peak in each continent. And our guest today has already conquered 4 of the 7, and he'll be soon going to conquer Mount Everest, which is the highest mountain in the world, very soon. And according to the information over here, he's going to conquer it in next March. So right now, we welcome our guest to this interview.
Hi.
Sir, today the first question will be like, what does mountaineering mean to you?
Mountaineering, to me, is a manifestation of the adventurous self. It is a medium through which I am giving shape to my dreams. It is also a medium through which I am breaking the so-called perceived barriers, so-called limits. I was an asthmatic patient before, and when I was small, till my college days. So thinking of mountaineering was, even the dream was a forbidden dream. But again, the adventurous self always asks you to push the limits that has been put around you. And you're doing something illogical. And breaking the barriers, breaking the patterns is mountaineering for me.
Yeah. See, that was the answer from our guest. So as we move on to the next question. As I studied your profile, I came to know that you had asthma since your childhood. So how did you conquer asthma and pursue into mountaineering and conquer all those peaks?
Yeah, I was not even been able to run 100 meters in those school competitions.
Yes.
I always used to have an inhaler in my pocket. But again, it cannot be a barrier for you to think big, really big. So my dreams were never chained by this limit, physical limit that I had. But when I was in college, I realized that I cannot depend on these inhalers for long. I need to get out of it. And then I started doing a lot of things, I was allergic to a lot of foods, which used to trigger asthma. I used to take those allergic foods more often, and I used to sneeze, I used to have breathlessness, but I used to have anti-allergic and I used to have food. And slowly I stopped the anti-allergic and I used to let it happen to me. So through those, and I made myself believe that it is not there. I totally denied that it is there. And eventually, so many years, it took like 4 to 5 years for me to come out of that. And I see it's a lot more psychological. And if you can make yourself believe, it's really possible. And eventually now, I can run a marathon. Half marathon. I can now have the guts to climb the highest mountain in the world. So nothing is impossible.
See, that's what we learned from our guest. Nothing is impossible. Hard work is the key to success. So which motivates all of us to work towards our goal very hard. So I would like to, this is my personal question. Why did you choose mountaineering? Because there were many other sports where you could prove yourself. They were like swimming, like trekking, like rock climbing. But sir, why mountaineering?
Well, I actually started doing this, started with mountaineering in very late. As late as 2010. But before that, I started doing treks. treks in the Western Ghats, and I used to visit the national parks. So it kindles in you the adventurous spirit. When I was doing those, I never ever thought that I would be going into mountaineering. I even did horse riding, I did paragliding, but mountaineering was never an option for me. I mean, I never gave it a thought. But one fine day in 2010 December, I got to see one advertisement on Everest Base Camp, and it fascinated me that what it would be like trekking in high altitude. And eventually, I just blindly went and registered without doing any study on where am I going and why am I going. I just followed what my heart said. And once I went there in the Everest Base Camp, the next few days actually changed the course of my life. When you see Everest in front of you, like staring at you, I mean, like it has an attraction, like strong attraction. So when you see it, like look at it, I mean, like it hypnotizes you. And I really fell in love with that mountain without knowing what Mount Everest actually is, what the dangers are. I mean, like, it was more a romantic decision to go for it. But when I came back, so that time I promised that one day I am going to come back to climb this mountain. Then I came back, I heard a lot of stories about the mountain, and I started studying about the mountain. Only then I came to know that how dangerous this mountain was, and it's not like today, I think, and tomorrow I go. It requires a lot of dedication and practice and skills. So it's not just a dream. If you have to give a shape to the dream, you really need to work hard towards it. You have to arrange the finance. It's like 18 lakhs to climb the Mount Everest. You need to work on your skills. You need to work on your fitness. And so many things. You need to work on your mental strength. So then I decided that I have to go for a formal training on mountaineering. And I went to Himalayan Mountaineering Institute, Darjeeling, in 2011 and did my course. Again, it was again a paradigm change altogether. You start respecting mountain more after that, and plus you were skilled. So the attitude towards mountain changed, and then came respect towards mountain. Then we thought that we understood that what we claimed, that we conquered this mountain and that mountain. We actually cannot conquer any mountain. We cannot conquer nature. It is merely that the mountain allowed us to reach to that top. If the mountain wouldn't have allowed, nobody can ever go to those mountains. So then that attitude of conquering changed to attitude towards a gratitude kind of.
That's a very fascinating story, sir. It would really motivate all our young crowd which is watching this interview today, because most of the crowd is of MBA students. So what we would learn, like even I am an MBA, so what we would learn is like when you have a dream, we just can't simply dream and achieve it the next day. We have to work for a very long time, we have to dedicate ourselves, we have to work hard. And that's why at the end, we reach to a goal. So, as I'm coming to the end of the interview, there is one last question which I'd like to ask you. The last question is this. Today, just now around us, we have a lot of youth. And if you see the population of India, more than 50% is a very young population. So, what message would you like to give to the young population, or all those students who are watching this interview today?
Right. So, you know, you need not to be a physical entity. It is there in our heart, in everyone's heart. For a student, the highest mountain for him is the challenge is just before the exam. So that exam is the mountain for him. For a job aspirant, to get that desired job is that target mountain for him. Right? So we climb mountains of all shapes and sizes. Even there are mountains taller than Mount Everest right in our heart, and we strive to climb that barrier or that mountain. So what I can say is, if you have a dream, preserve it. However illogical it might seem like, however the current circumstances tell you that the dream is not possible, if you really believe that it can be done, it definitely can be done. So all you need is that grit, that determination. Give whatever it takes to reach that particular dream, to give a light to that particular dream. And nothing can stop you. Nothing in this world can stop you from achieving that. All the best.
Those were the guests from our words, which makes us all think. Dreaming is very easy, but achieving that dream is very difficult. Hard work is the only key of success, is what we learned from our guest today. Nothing is impossible with hard work. Once we work hard, it is easy. We can achieve our goals. We need dedication. We need perseverance. We need a lot of values, a lot of skills in today's world. So at the end, what we'd like to say is, work towards your goal and achieve your goal and conquer the mountains. Thank you, sir. It was a great, immense pleasure of having you here today.
It's a pleasure to
be here. Thank you.